Hey guys, so today I created this look with the new Morphe James Charles Artistry palette. So if you want to see how I got this look and my opinion on this palette, go ahead and keep on watching. I just want to start out by saying that I'm so excited for this palette. I think this palette is what we have needed in the beauty community ever since the 35B was discontinued. In my opinion, this palette has every matte colorful eyeshadow you could ever need. So in James's video with the palette, he let people know that this palette works best with a regular eye primer and not a concealer as your eye base. But my problem is that I don't even own an eye primer. I haven't used like a real eyeshadow primer in 3 years, I would say. I've always just used a concealer and a translucent powder to prep my eyes for eyeshadow. I do that with every single one of my looks, every single palette I've used, and it works perfectly for me. So I'm a little unsure as to why that wouldn't work with this palette. I know they're super pigmented and they're more like pressed pigments, but I think it should work okay. So I prepped my eye with the Too Faced Born This Way Concealer in Snow. This is what I've used for the past few months or so, ever since it launched really. And I set my entire eye area with the RCMA Loose Powder. So I'm not gonna follow James's instructions, and I'm gonna try doing my eyeshadow with the concealer base instead of an eye primer. If it goes wrong, then that's totally my fault because I didn't listen to the instructions, and I'm gonna have to go out and buy one. If this palette does work with my concealer as a base, then I'll be really, really happy. Because these shadows are more like pressed pigments, I'm gonna do more packing motions instead of blending motions today. Sorry that was a long intro, but I had a lot to say, so let's get started. I'm gonna take the shade 518 on a Sigma E32, and I'm gonna pack this in my crease. And I'm just really gonna build up this color. Then I'm gonna use this brush to softly blend. I'm gonna pick up the shade B on a Sigma E25, and I'm gonna use that to help blend out the edges of the orange. I'm gonna take a Sigma E36 in the shade You're Kidding, and I'm gonna use this to deepen and define my crease. The shade is so bright. Now I'm gonna go back in with more 518 on the same E36 and use that to help blend. Now I'm gonna take Love That on my E36. And I'm gonna go a little bit lower than that red color, but I'm gonna still do the same back and forth motion. These shades look so bright and neon in person, it's so crazy. So I'm bringing this Love That shade kind of lower towards my lid. I can't decide if I want to do a cut crease and put the purple on my lid, or just kind of smoke the purple up this way by packing it on. I don't know. Okay, I think I want to pack the purple on. So I'm going to take Escape on my E32, and I'm going to pack that on the lower part of my lid. This is the prettiest dark purple ever, and I am getting some fallout with this shade. Now I'm going to start to softly blend that up. I packed some translucent powder under my eye just because it was getting a little crazy under there. I'm gonna take my E25 and just blend that purple. So I'm mostly just blending on my lid so it looks like a gradient from that purple all the way up to the yellow. Going for like a full smoky sunset right now. And if you lose any of the intensity of the colors, you can just go back and touch them up. I'm gonna take more Love That on my E32. And I'm just gonna pat that where it was on my lid. And then I'm gonna take more Escape, that dark purple, and just touch it up one more time. I'm gonna take more Love That on my E36, and I'm gonna blend that along my lower lash line. I'm gonna take more 518 on the same brush, and I'm gonna blend slightly below the pink. And then a little bit of the yellow. I'm going to take a Sigma E21 with Escape on it, and I'm going to use that to deepen up the lower lash line kind of right in between my lashes. This Escape shade has a lot of fallout, but it's so pretty. I don't know if I want to do a wing or just like a smoky eyeliner. I wish you guys were here to like tell me what to do, you know? Okay, I think I'm going to do a wing just because I'm feeling bold today, obviously. You could of course do any type of eyeliner you want. I feel like any style would go well with this look. I'm going to use the Charlotte Tilbury Feline Flick Pen. I think mine's getting a little dried out. That's sad. I need a new one. I'm switching to the Fenty one. Not my best eyeliner in the world. I kept messing up, so I made it a little bit too long and it needs to be pointed upwards just a little bit more, but this is what I'm working with. I'm gonna take the shade Ring Light on a Sigma L04 and I'm gonna use that to highlight. Now I'm gonna pop on some mascara and lashes. So I did put a little bit of a black eyeliner in my waterline just to even everything out. And for lashes, I used Lily Lashes Miami. I know these lashes are huge on me. I am well aware, but they're pretty glam, you know? And here is the final look. I think this look is so, so pretty. I'm pretty sure I did a similar tutorial with the Lunar Beauty Life's a Drag palette, but I mean, you can't go wrong with like a sunset smoky eye. The colors are absolutely beautiful in this palette as we know. I didn't have any issues using my concealer as my eye primer, but I did notice some of the shades were kind of powdery, so maybe next time I'm gonna try it without setting my concealer, because then I think the shadows would stick a little bit better. But other than that, I'm very happy with this palette. The colors were even brighter than I expected to show up on my eye, so let me know what other colors you want me to use from this palette. There are many, many color combos we can do. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe.